Hey, Jim Bergman with measureQuick. Wanted to go over some of the updates we've done to the heating section, because if you haven't looked at measureQuick for a while on the heating side, this is the year to do it. We have made just a huge amount of updates to the interface that make gas heating a lot easier to use, and it meets you where you're at. And what I mean by that is, if you don't own a combustion analyzer, you can still get a lot out of measureQuick. And let me just show you here what we've got. So right now I have this set up. I have it set up for everything. So you can see on one screen now, we can view our diagnostics. We can look at all the readings. We can see what's in range, what's out of range. Right now you can see that I have a low manifold pressure at 3.34 inches. It's within acceptable, but it's resulting in a little bit low of gas heat input, which I could dial it up. You can see I have high static pressure. And if I tap on any one of these, it'll tell me, you know, what the total external static pressure is and how it's used. But you can also see on the left-hand side of the screen, the way I have it configured, that it's looking at our gas inputs low, CO ambient temperatures meted, we have a low stack temperature, we have a high O2, we have high static pressure, right? So diagnostics now built in for the combustion analysis as well as the furnace. Now, down at the bottom here, I think a couple of cool things are. We can start and stop the combustion analyzer right from measureQuick. So if I hit the stop screen here, it'll lock those readings in. And then down here below that, I can do my test setup. So if I check off that I'm not performing a combustion analysis or measuring ambient CO, you can see right away our diagnostics change, but also our interface changes. So you only see what you need. So it makes it a lot better. So if you're standing there, there's customers behind you, you're not doing a combustion analysis because you don't own one yet, you're only seeing on the screen the inlet pressure, the manifold pressure, their induced draft pressure, our static pressures. And this, again, this is where we highly recommend that you get multiple manometers. I have 5 manometers on here. I'm measuring the incoming gas pressure, the manifold pressure, return static, supply static, induced draft pressure. And this is all because furnaces are dynamic. Things are running, and we want to see everything that's happening at once. So as I dial my gas pressure up and down, that changes my input, that changes my temperature rise, that could change it. In this case, if it's got a supply air temperature sensor, or if it was a modulating furnace with a supply air temperature sensor, would change my airflow and other things. So all these things work together, and being able to have those manometers on there, which is a fairly low investment, because I can get this all set up, makes this really, really fast. So again, we've added in a lot of new diagnostics. We've added in a lot of new help screens. We've added in a lot of new interfaces in here, and it will really change the way that you work with measureQuick.